Hey guys, Tikwani here, and in this video I want to show you how you can duplicate the entire website from one location to a completely different location. Now this can be very useful if you create, you know, several different sites, you know, that are exactly the same. Maybe you build AdSense sites, or maybe you're a developer and you create same sites over and over again using the same plugins and themes or something like that. And if you do any of those things, this will save you a ton of time. So here is a demo site that I've created on this domain. That's ewbdemo.info. So as you can see, this is a pretty fair new installation of WordPress. I got 9 posts, 6 pages, 6 categories, 5 comments, and all of them are approved. And if I go to maybe users, you'll see that I have a few users available there. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one is admin, subscriber, editor, author, and contributor. So I got 5 users, and I got few plugins. So if I go to plugins, and if I go to install plugins, you'll see that I have few plugins installed over here. 7 plugins installed. Now, when this can be useful is especially when using plugins like this one, SEO by Yoast, or maybe this relevancy plugin. It's basically a search engine for your WordPress site. These plugins have a ton of options. So if you use these same plugins over and over again on different site, you know, you'll be wasting your time. It will easily take me 30 minutes to configure. Maybe if not 30, if I'm doing this every day, it will still take me quite a bit amount of time if I'm doing it every day to configure. You can see how many options it has got. So why not just make a complete clone of the site and just, you know, deploy that clone whenever I want to create the exact same site. So that's what I'm going to show you in this video. So to do that, what I'm going to do is go to plugins and click on add new. And I'm going to search for the plugin called Duplicator. Alright, it's a great plugin. I'm using it on different sites, so I'm not going to go ahead and check the details if it's compatible with the latest release of WordPress. But if you want to do that, feel free to do it. But I know that it works, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go ahead and install this plugin and activate it very quick. And once you activate it, you will see this option called Duplicator over here. I wanted to click on this dashboard option. Once you come in this dashboard, you need to check this system check. If you're running on any, you know, good web host, this shouldn't be an issue. But just to double check, you click on this check and it will just pass the minimum requirements like MySQL support and PHP support and all of that. And if you see all of this pass and this good, that means you're good to go. So just click on this close button over here. And you know what, you can call it whatever you want, the package name. So I'm going to call it my clone. Alright, and then you need to click on this little icon that says create package. Now depending on how big your site is, it's going to take time. Alright, let's say you run a blog maybe since last few years and you got a lot of content, then it's going to take some time, so just be patient. But this one was a fairly new installation of WordPress, so it just took like, you know, a few seconds. As you can see, the size is just 12 megs. It's not a pretty big size. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to download this installer. Just click on this, and I'm also going to go ahead and click on this package. So I'm going to download the installer and package. So again, depending on how big your package is, what this package contains is your entire WordPress files, your all the content, meaning your media. So if you have a lot of images uploaded, or maybe a few videos or zip files, everything is included. And if you have a lot of themes, a lot of plugins, so depending on how big your site is, it's going to take time, and also on the internet speed. So just click on those two options and just wait for a few seconds. I'm going to pause this video and come back right after the download is finished. Alright, so the download has been finished. As you can see, I have my installer.php file and my entire website package in the zip file. So what I've done is I have uploaded these two files, this entire package and the installer.php file, to the new domain that I want to completely deploy this site. So that's hqcelebrityphotos.com. As you can see in this directory, there is two files that I've uploaded right now. I didn't want to waste your time and see you uploading me these files here. And if I go to this domain name, you will see there's nothing in there, and that's why this default page of my web hosting company shows up. So there are just two files. The one is a zip file of my entire clone, and another is installer.php. So what I need to do now is go to my domain name, whatever it is, /installer.php, Again, or when you go to this page, it needs to say system requirement pass. If instead of this green light, there's a red light, there that means something is wrong, then just click on this button, will show you what the issue is. Now what I've done is also created a database name and a password for that, so that we can just use that database. So here's my database name, my database user, and here's my database password. Alright, and you need to click on both of these options, database creation and database table removal. Basically, it will remove the tables of this database and will create, you know, the new tables. And if you want to test the connection to make sure that the username and password you have entered are correct, you can click on this button, but I'm pretty sure they're right because I just created it. So I'm not going to do that, and I'm going to just check on this. I have read all the warnings, and you don't have to worry about these two options, database setup help and advanced option. Let me just click on them. There are not much options available for you guys here, so I usually don't worry about these. So I'm just going to go check on this. I have read all the warnings and notices, and I'm going to click on this run deployment. And we'll just give you a pop-up, and you need to hit OK. Now this one again depends on how big your database file is. So if you have a lot of data and a lot of content, it may take some time. But this one was a fairly new installation, so it didn't take any time. All you need to change on this page is change the title of your website. So previous domain was EWB demo. So in this one is HQ Celebrity Photos. So I'm just going to go ahead and change the title of my site to whatever the new title I want it to be. So I will just call it HQ Celebrity Photos. And if you want any advanced option, again, there are not much options available for you guys. It basically does what you want it to do by itself, so you don't have to worry about it. Just hide those advanced options and use this button that says update tables, and it will just replace the data, and may take a few seconds, and there you go. You just need to now take a couple of different steps. You need to resave your permalink settings. So I'm just gonna go ahead and open this in the new tab. So I have this new tab open here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and click on save as a post name, and I'm just gonna close this site. And you need to make sure you delete these installer files, because all of these files are in your public_HTML directory. That means they're visible by anyone who has a direct location. So you need to make sure that you delete these files, or as you know, someone might be able to just download the entire clone of your site. So just click on that button, and it will, you know, basically go ahead and delete all of those files of this, you know, Duplicator plugin. Not the entire plugin, but just the, you know, files that you uploaded and kind of stuff. And the last step is to just to test your entire site, and if there are any errors, it's gonna show you some reports, but it says deploy error 0, update error 0, warning 0, so I don't have to worry about it. And I'm just gonna go and click on the site that says test entire site, and it will open up a new window, and I'll just hit refresh, and it should just work. As you can see, I have a new website working on this completely different location, that's hqcelebrityphotos.com. And if I go to WP admin area, you'll see, let me just close this one right now, and also this one. Alright, so here is my previous website, the old domain name, ewbdemo.info. If I go to dashboard, and I'm on the dashboard of this one too, so here's a different location, HQ Celebrity Photos. As you can see, 9 posts, 6 pages, 6 categories, 5 comments, 5 approved. That's exactly what we have in the previous site, 96655. Alright, so if I go back to my users in this new website and click on all users, you see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 users. One is admin, one is subscriber, editor, author, and contributor. If I go to plugins, you will see I have all the plugins. So basically, instead of me going in and installing different plugins, installing different themes, and customizing each plugin for each site, basically doing the same old mundane task every day, this plugin will just, you know, duplicate the entire site in few clicks for me. And you don't have to actually download this package again and again, since I have downloaded this package once from this site. And if I don't make any changes in this site, and that's the exact sites, let's say I sell to my different clients, you know, again and again, I don't have to download it again. Alright, I already got a downloaded copy. All I need to do is upload that installer.php file and that package to their, server and just click few buttons and I'll be good to go. Now I want to hear from you. How do you clone your site, or if you got any error while cloning and deploying your site with the help of this plugin Duplicator? So come on over to effortlesswp.com and leave your comments there and let me know. And if you found this video helpful, make sure to share it with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for watching this video. This is Bert Taekwani signing off. I'll see you soon. Bye.